Welcome back, everyone. And first, let's land this airship. So, at the end of the last episode, I was discussing what I was going to do with my party and things like that. First off, in this town of Tizen, there is... Oh, no! Whew, don't scare people like that. Thought you were a trooper. Blah, blah, blah. This dude just randomly talks, and he's a thief, though you can't really see him through the trees, and he jacked a magicite for 3 grand. Yeah. We'll buy that. We'll buy some Seraphim. There you go. You can see he's a thief. And I also bought... Come on, get out of my way. Get out of my way. Get out of my way. I don't know if that was this episode or last time. This episode. I don't remember when. Just in case I didn't go over. But I also managed to buy... I guess all range items is what I'm going to misclick. I also managed to buy Golem and Zone Seek, which I think I mentioned this. Not quite sure. But they're cool. I got these two at the auction house, and then we just picked up this one. Teaches life fairly quickly. Another caster of Remedy, which I think Unicorn teaches that, but it teaches it slowly. And then, of course, really fast Cure 2, Cure Regen. It's just a very nice curing type of thing. I think Unicorn teaches Remedy. Yeah, it does. Oh, 3, that's not terrible, but whatever. So there we go, and I'm gonna go with this party. Mog is actually a beast. I freaking got him at level 22 and didn't even realize, so that was awesome. And then his special ability is Dance, which we will see, and I went ahead and got a couple of extra dances as well. He only starts with Dusk Requiem, so I went ahead and got these 4 for him, which just means that you have to fight in a certain area with different colored terrains, different backgrounds. Like, fight in a forest, he'll learn this one. You fight in the desert, he'll learn that one. It's pretty simple. And so that's where we stand right now. So we are going to go on our way. Dun, 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 dun. So there's Vector, just so you know which town I bought the Seraphim from. I believe we are all good to go into the Imperial base and over to where we think the sealed gate is. So, that's... Whoa. Alright. Imperial base... Okay, so I'm trying to remember everything that we've done. We've already been here and looked in the treasure room we can't get to yet. And voila! Here we are. I'm going to save my game. Let's make it happen, boys! Alright, everybody, welcome back. I did not mean to go there. I apologize for the last 2 minutes or whatever. I was, like, really distracted and I had to get to work, but I really wanted to do some slight recording before I headed off while it was on my mind and, you know, whatever, and I had just no idea what was going on, so here we are now. What did I just pick up? Picked up an assassin! So just consider this the start of the video instead, eh? Randomly dispatches an enemy. Ah, this is good with Lock and Shadow, but not here. If you equip it on them here, it's actually going to make things more difficult for you. So, figured I should point that out. Dun, 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 dun. So this is the cave to the sealed gate. Ah, I got crap. I'm going to get crap a lot with, crap, which one is the cave one? With Setzer's slots. It's just... kinda gotta happen. Okay, I picked correctly. The dances are kinda cool, as obviously you can just completely eliminate an enemy if you want. Dances, what they do is they change the terrain of, like, the background picture of whatever you see. Great, now I just got imped a bunch because I'm not really trying very hard. and whichever dance you pick, if you're already in that terrain, it'll automatically work, guaranteed. If you try and do a dance of a different terrain, it'll have a chance to fail. Misclicks all over the place. So, you want to... I don't think any of you guys know Imp, do you? So you want to pick the dance of the terrain that you're currently on. Sweet, you know Imp. And you also know Float. Let's just put Float on everybody. And then once you do dance, there's like 4 different commands Mog can actually do. He picks him at random. You no longer have control. Sweet, a Tempest. Tempest is one of the best swords. Its battle power is not that high. It has a very high chance to cast a powerful all-target wind spell. So it ends up getting up there in power, even if its power itself wasn't very high. Sweet, I got a slot. Alright, so we're gonna dance with... Let's try Wind Song, just to show all these other dances. They're all fairly powerful, too, so... Mog is not a bad character. That's another good thing about this game, like, they give you so many characters, and you're just like, man, what am I supposed to use, blah blah blah. They're all worthwhile. Yeah, see, that's the spell Tempest casts, when you hit dudes with it. Kind of like how the Bolt Beam Swords, Flame Saber, Blizzard, and crap like that sometimes casted Bolt 1 and Ice 1 and stuff when you smack them. Tempest, that's what that does. So, alright, so here we go. We got a little puzzle here. And these things randomly change every, like, 3 seconds. And you gotta kind of pay attention to where these things are, which it's usually really simple. It's usually... I wasn't looking for this one. I got it anyway. Coin toss. It's worthless. I don't want it. Crap. Okay, now I want to get that treasure chest, so I want to... Okay, I want to stand there. Yeah, it's usually pretty simple, just like the farthest path that you can take a step on, so it's not too big of a deal. And you have to actually step on that one to make it start. Okay, so go all the way down. I think I gotta go here. And I wasn't looking. Crap. Okay, good, I made it. Now let's see here. This place is a little bit of a maze, which is cool because this dungeon is awesome. The music is sweet. Everything about this place is sweet. Oh, almost got triple bar. Actually, no. You want to use Cyan as your last character because his sword techniques take forever to get up there. So while Mog is wasting time dancing, I'm not actually losing time by sitting there doing nothing. Cave in! Sweet, that's the one I wanted. Because those guys, if you use an instant kill attack on them, it doesn't work. It just fully restores them because they're undead, so... Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I don't think you want to use fire in this cave either, so... Alright, Mog just learned a couple spells. That's cool. Everyone's fully equipped. Random battles. Zombone. Now these guys you can use fire on, I believe. Alright, you're gonna go last. You're gonna dance Dusk Requiem. You're gonna slot just because that's what you're supposed to do. And then you... Do you know fire? You only know fire one. Well, we'll just cast it. I didn't think that would work. I thought that would bring the guy back. The cave-in, or not the cave-in, the sinkhole, whatever the hell it was. Sweet. Well, no big deal. We'll just smash that guy for 900 points of magical smack. And then 550 points of that. Seems okay. Boom! Did you guys see it? 3,500. See, Mog, he can be awesome. And he can wear one of the best relics in the game that I think only him and maybe one other character can. It might just be him, actually. It's just him. I'm crazy. It's named after him, so yeah, he's the only one. Alright, Terra's gonna smack. You're gonna smack. You're gonna dance again. And then you're gonna sword tech. Ugh, see, Setzer's base damage is just so bad. You have to use slot, even though most of the time with slot, you're gonna get nothing. Even Cave-In hurts, though, so that's nice. Seems okay. Come on, Mog. Make it happen. So we are on our way to the sealed gates where the Esper Realm is. And what shall we find there? We shall find out when we get there. There's a lot of important treasure in this cave, too, so we want to make sure we grab it all. I was like, oh, that's right, back this way. Losing my mind. Let's see here. What's behind this way? I don't know my way around here as well as I should. Ah, these guys take forever. I don't want to fight them. Maybe I should just equip Flame Saber. I don't remember if it heals those other guys or not. I'll have to find out, because if it doesn't, then absolutely flame. Whoa! She can morph now? She couldn't morph, like, 2 seconds ago. I wonder if she leveled up and that's what triggered it. Of course, splitting damage between everybody doesn't help. Whatever. Oh, a critical throw! And then, of course, elf fire for 5,000 damage. Nope, I wanted to go the other way. Ah, so many fights. This is gonna be a long video, guys. You probably are already aware, but this is just the way it's gonna be. Cause I don't want to break this crap up. I'm tired of always being so worried about video time. It's making the LP worse. So I'm just gonna roll with what I got here. Let's try casting Drain. Cause she's low on hit points. Oh no, they're undead. That's actually really bad. That's gonna hurt me. That might even kill me. Oh nice, I got the airship. Alright, let's see if this kills me or not. Okay. Well, it gave me the white and him the green, so if it hurt, or if it worked, it would have hurt me, but instead it just missed, so that's fine. H-bomb, here we go. That's what you get from the airship slots. Ba-ba-ba-ba-boom! I don't know how you call the airship mid-combat in a cave, but we do. God, these fights are starting to take forever. I'm doing something wrong. I don't know what I'm doing wrong, but I'm doing something wrong. They should not all be taking this long. Alright, I'm going to give her a break and flame, just to see. And then someone's gonna cure. Mog can cure. I don't need it that bad. You need it, though. We'll go with that. What do you have? Who's got the... You've got Tintinnabar. That's okay. Alright. Oh, I could've just gone... Oh, I could've just gone that other way. Anyway, but I needed to hit that switch to hear a distant sound, which is that little bridge up there by that treasure chest I couldn't get before. Okay, let's try and speed this up a little bit, eh? Nope, I'm gonna miss. Alright, let's see if Terra's new weapon's actually gonna be beneficial. There you go, get elf fire first. Unless you absorb fire, that would suck. No, they absorb fire, I knew it. Oh, triple bar! Sick. Sick, sick, sick. Alright, well that was not beneficial. Flame Saber's not gonna work here. Where did it go? Give me a blizzard. Thank you. Alright, what triple bar does is it casts a random Esper, I believe, a random summon spell, and I have absolutely no idea what one that just was. I honestly don't know. But maybe I'm wrong on that. I suppose I could be wrong on that. I've only ever gotten triple bar like 3 times in my life, so I can't say for certain. Alright, bringing Setzer along was a bad idea. He's the one slowing me down, because he does nothing half the time. If not for Mog, this would be impossible. I just wanted to bring different characters. Like, I seriously never use Mog, Cyan, or Setzer, so... Alright, sweet, we got another Genji Glove, which right now, I don't want to equip it. If I was able to steal the other Tempest from a boss earlier that I tried and couldn't, I absolutely would. Because then I would just dual-wield Tempests, but... Oh well. No big deal. Nice, I got the free break. Oh, it missed though. Right, you need something else to do, man. Try fire. Oh, That works. Oh, it missed! Dang it. I didn't know that could miss. So again, I'll apologize about the video time on this one, but I'm gonna try to start like not caring about it. But if you want to skim through some of the battles, I wouldn't blame you. Because there's a lot in this place. Simply because there's so much exploring I have to do. And you're gone. And because I brought Setzer, which was probably a bad idea. Just healing him up a little bit. Alright, so we got the Genji Glove. Man, I've only gotten one treasure chest and 13 minutes have gone by on this segment. Alright. What can you do that's powerful? You can't do anything powerful. All you can do is hit people. There is a quote-unquote glitch with the slots. If you keep pausing the video, you know, as the slots are going down, you can kind of rig what you're gonna get. But that takes even longer, in my opinion, and it's really, really lame, but whatever. It's not foolproof either, especially with my controller, it wouldn't be. Poison Frog. That's a new one. Oh, great. Thanks, Mog. Oh, I got the H-Bomb again. I should not have brought Setzer. He's wasting all sorts of time. Kill him. Alright. Someone needs curing. What are you? You're learning Bismarck. You're learning Ramu. You're learning Phantom. Are you done with Phantom? I haven't even been checking. You're learning Golem. You're not done yet. Bismarck for life. Okay, well. At least now. Ha! Progressed. Dope! Yeah, it didn't help that I didn't realize there were stairs right there and I turned around the wrong way. That wasted a lot of time. At least we'll get 7 flush right there with that slot, that's cool. Seven flush isn't terrible. Man, maybe I shouldn't use this dance against those guys, because two of them don't even hurt. Oh, H-Bomb, nice. I think maybe I should just put Cyan in the front and just start attacking with him, trying to get Tempest to trigger. We'll give that a shot. And then we'll switch you two. And maybe instead of True Knight, I can give you a double Hyper. Let's do that. Let's give you double Hyper Wrist and see how well this works. Alright, 2 switches here. Oh, snap! A ninja just fell down on me. That's gonna hurt. That might kill Terra. Oof, came close. Oh, that's it? Only 271? Oh, crap. I would have everybody set on basic attack as he... Oh, triple bo- No way! Absolutely no way! That's awesome. Oh, I just died. Almost. Oh, no, 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 no. Come on, Mog, it's all up to you. Oh, my goodness. Mog saving my life. I thought I had the monopoly on the stuff buried in the plaza beneath the grand stairway. So there's stuff in a plaza and some grand stairway. I love how Mog is trying to learn life, but he's not quite there yet, so I have to burn a couple Phoenix Downs. Does anyone else know life? I don't think anyone else does. We'll bring you guys back for now. Mostly because I know that there's a save point in here where I was just gonna tent. Yeah, I just wanted to make sure I didn't get into a random battle and died for it. So, where are my tents, though? And Mog has a white tent with a little pink pom-pom on top. Appropriate. I'm gonna recast Float just because I can. And let's keep going. After getting destroyed by that ninja. Big stairwell. Let's go grab this item over here. Actually, you know what? Have Setzer summon his Esper, Phantom. It'll make all my characters invisible, which will make them immune to physical attacks. That seems okay. Oh, that means I can't use Mugu Mugu, I guess. I think. Because I believe using that would unviz all of my guys. So, hopefully I won't need the curing, but that means no more slot. So Setzer now officially is gonna suck. But what can you do? Let's change you back. I guess you don't really need True Knight anymore, though. I guess I can give you... I could give you Black Belt, but that'd be kind of dumb. I'll just leave you with True Knight. I don't think it matters at this point. Put you back in the back and put you back there. Granted, there's still some enemies that'll use magic on me, but... I'd much rather have everyone invisible than not. It should make things go a lot smoother and... And I would use other dances, but again, I don't want them to have the chance of failing. And some of them cast stuff that cures my party as well, which now at this point would ruin all my invisibility-ness, so... I'm not quite going to do that anymore. You're not dead. There you go. Nice. Terra finally learned her stuff. So now I can give her a new Esper. And I was just thinking, I don't need Tintinnabar on you anymore. I can give you Atlas Armlet. And I think I could actually give you Hyper Wrist as well, and then you could take Sprint Shoes. Where'd they go? I just saw them. There. And you can go for a new Esper now. How about Seraphim? Regain and Remedy? Not interested. Oh no, Mauden. Yeah, you need the level 2 spells. That's what you need. So, equip your father. Alright, how do I get... up here? Ah, let me up there! Walking through the invisible walls. I wish I wouldn't fight these guys so often. They take too long. Thank you. There you go. Ugh, God, that was a critical and... Well, actually, no, if these guys are only doing 200, maybe that damage isn't that bad. Elixir! Go figure. Maybe I can just run. If I'm gonna be invisible from all these battles, I'm just gonna start running from some of them. There we go, fighting some Ings again. Well, these guys' Life Shaver will take away my my invisibility. But I think that's the only thing they can do. And there goes one, so that's good. Ah. Ouch! Straight up killed him? That's impressive. Poor Setzer. I think I'll just wait for Mog to learn life. Oh, he's only at 40%. Oh, you know life. That's cool, then. And Mog knows Cure, too. There you go, piece of cake. Flick it. Flick that while I'm at it. And then I need to get in there. Ah! Battles everywhere. Lots of switches. Pretty much, RPGs are funny in the way that, like... Regardless of what you're doing, if there's a switch, it's always in the off position, so just hit it, you know? If there's ever a lever, or a button, or a switch, just hit it. It's like in the Pokemon House, in the Red version. You walk up to those things that change the door, and it's like, you find a hidden switch, press it, you say yes, it's like, who wouldn't? Like, duh, of course you're gonna push that hidden switch. On Cinnabar Island. Level up! Everyone's leveling up! There we go. This is where I wanted to get to. Magicite. Ether. Now that Magicite is not actually a piece of Magicite Esper. It's like a Magicite shard that I can use as an item, and it will summon a random Esper in battle. So it's not actually very worthwhile. Atma freaking weapon, however, indeed is. Take a gander at this. Boom! 375 battle power. It's a little wonky, that's not actually how it properly works. It's a sword that grows with your character. Like, the more you level up, the sword can level up as well. And the higher your HP, the more powerful it is. So, right now in the game, even though it would give me 255 battle power if I equipped it by itself, it's not actually that powerful right now, but fairly soon, that will be a mandatory equip somewhere on someone at all times. But for right now, I'm better off with Blizzard Blade. Kill the Ying! Kill the Ying! Oh well. I guess you killed somebody, that's fine. And now that I gave Setzer those two fight relics, his fight damage is actually worthwhile enough. Yeah, if Dispatch is doing 600 and Setzer's hitting for 400, that's totally fine. I guess if everyone's invisible, I can get someone else in the front row. Just to see other sprites. So where... else do I need to go now? The two most important treasures in this place were the Genji Glove and the Atma Weapon, so I got those. So if I miss something else, it's not critical. It would just be nice to get it all, but I shouldn't be missing anything. Oh, select... What are you doing? That guy, thank you. Ugh, whatever. It was all for naught. Got him. Alright, flip this switch, because I have to. Flip this switch, because I have to. And flick that one again. Whoops. Flip. I think I hit it one too many times. Because I hit it that first time, and I'm not quite sure if I was supposed to. I think I'm supposed to hit it once. I don't know what I'm doing. God, I should have put Phantom on a lot earlier. Phantom is really good as a summon. I mean, it depends on the area, because some areas will have a lot of magic cast against you, and then it's obviously not nearly as beneficial. But if stuff is mostly physical, like this place is almost entirely physical, absolutely. I don't have to worry about a thing right now. Wait, whoa, whoa, whoa. This was not connected before that random battle. Whatever. The random battle worked. So, whatever. Now I'm picking up lots of Magicite. And I think that's all the treasure. I think I got everything, guys. Okay, it wasn't quite as long as I remember, if that's the case. I guess we'll see in whatever rooms are coming up how much is left. Ouch, that's gonna hurt, isn't it? Nope. At least it gets rid of her invis, but... Nice. Sets her with some shades on? That looks fitting. That looks fitting. I'll leave those on. See, he's ostentatiously fashionable, like plot. I don't know, that word's so hard to pronounce, I never even know. I'll just run from these guys. I guess I should run more often. Alright, can I go... Is there something this way? No, just up. Alrighty, here we are. At the sealed gate. I'm gonna save this for next time, too. I think. There we go. This is the sealed gate. And this is the end of our episode. So check us out next time, guys. Take it easy. Peace.